Hi, Shay Given here. You're watching Irish Football Fan TV.
Hello and welcome back to Irish Football Fan TV. Today I'm here with Jonathan Higgins from the ARW podcast. Did I get that right?
You did. The official ARW on Twitter. Give us a follow.
Yeah, don't forget to check them out, especially Liverpool fans or fans of football in general.
Exactly.
This is our preview show for the first leg between Denmark and Ireland in Copenhagen. How do you fancy our chances?
Quietly confident.
Why so?
Because I think we will go over. We'll go over Saturday evening. I think we'll do a job on them. I see us being very, very compact, very structured. But I can see us getting a minimum of a draw, and I think we bring them back to Dublin. And you know, anything back in Dublin with the Lansdowne Road / Aviva bouncing.
Yeah, the only problem is you look at the Serbia game, and that's what kind of has me a little bit. Because we tried to play ball against Serbia.
I think we've learned our lessons, though, from that.
Yeah, to a degree, I would say.
The team selection in the Wales match, I think, kind of showed that lesson. It wasn't, you know, we're going to attack them, we're going to really take them on. This was going to be a bit more structured. We're going to hit them on the counter. Because there is an abundance of pace in that team. And we have a lot of quality ball player and midfield players as well. And, you know, we're set up just to flood the midfield and pretty much go the same again. Quietly confident. Look, let's be honest, Denmark... really, really good team. You know, Eriksen is, you know, he's one of the sprinkled players, one of the elite in European football at the moment.
He could
really play for any of the top European clubs team or the teams, and he's in good form as well. So he will be managed, and I think that's another reason why I think we need to kind of just swamp that midfield sector.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, they still have some like good players, like Sistal's a good winger,
good player,
and stuff
like
that. Yeah. But and Poulsen as well.
Yeah.
I look at us and I look at them, and you know, arguably you'd say they're better individual players in certain areas, but I think all round, and I always say this to a lot of people, is that we've a much better team and team spirit. Like, you can see when they go away, when they're all doing their Instagram stories and all, they're all very much together. Like,
to watch them, Myler and McLean sending rebel songs back to each other in the day.
Yeah, exactly. and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But like, and even, you know, they go around slagging each other and stuff like that. And you just see, there must be a lot of banter between it. And it's always kind of been that way with Ireland as well.
Mm-hmm.
I'm reading Shay Given's book at the moment, and kind of goes on about how they always make sure they had the crack when they were away with Ireland. It was just the thing to do. And everybody was included and stuff like that. So that's the thing. The camaraderie and everything seems to be there. Like, as we were talking before the show, like the likes of Coleman and Walters going over to join in with the squad.
That's a big enough example of anything, isn't it, to prove the point that you're just saying. What I think as well is, although, you know, you can look at our players on paper and you might say, look, they're not the best, but there's a couple of players in particular. McLean strikes out to me, for example, that...
he goes up about 10 levels.
They thrive, they're just made for this international football. And usually, you know, the top players kind of struggle in international football. Look at Ryan Giggs, he never played a game for Wales,
etc.
But... McLean, that's his level, that's his niche, is international football. You know, it's the one time he can control his aggression and funnel it out.
Sometimes
I know he goes over the edge, but like, you look at him playing for West Brom and you think, you'd look at the two players, and if you were a fool or didn't know they were the same player, you wouldn't put the two players together. It's funny, and there's a couple of other players like that. You even look, I know Ward's improved a bit now, but there's a lot of players there like that that really, really are thriving in that setup. So that's why I'm so excited. It's not like you look at the Denmark team, and you see the individual players and they're striking the eye. You look at our team, you don't. But as you said, that overall team structure is what.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Is like, you could see with the lads, they're all fight for each other. And the great thing is now you're looking at Duffy, and not so much Clark, but you're looking at Duffy, and he's in great form since the Wales game, especially. He's really upped his game.
Flying, and Brighton are flying as well, and he is a...
He's a key part of that, though.
Yeah, absolutely. He's on a crest of the wave at the moment there. He's absolutely flying, and that's down to his international form.
Yeah, and, it's like, I think he actually kind of makes Clark a better player.
Probably, yeah.
Or makes him look a better player.
Yeah,
maybe.
It's a decent partnership, you have to say.
I thought Kevin Long now, when he stepped in from Burnley, I thought he did well against Austria when he stepped in.
He did a decent game.
Don't there's a set of partnership, I suppose.
Yeah, it's like the keeper as well.
The back four and the keeper kind of picks itself, you know,
there's all the clamour to Elliot to get in goal on the basis of his Newcastle form, and I can kind of see that point to a degree. But
he was very good the other day.
He was really good form, but you, in my mind, you don't touch the keeper.
Yeah, to at least the end of the playoffs, and, then the friendlies come in, then kind of bet him in, see how he gets on, and then go from there. Same thing with Matt Doherty.
Yes.
Although Steve will probably argue with me about this.
Steelo's been the hipster choice, getting a few other players in there.
Yeah, well, he's been trying to get Matt Doherty in the squad, and he's been out there calling his name all the time. And long behold, there he's in the squad now.
Exactly.
So,
yeah.
And
clearly,
I think he made the final squad as well.
I think he did. Yes. Yeah.
Which is good, but Steve's also complaining now that there's no left back cover. Although there's O'Dowda there, but he's more of a winger than a left back. And then there's the worry that Brady drops back into left back rather than being a flair, but a flair, because when he's on it,
true. There's two ways of looking at it, really. If we're really, really going for it, I think Brady's more effective coming from deep. And especially if you say you're like really, really going for it, like we need a goal, or say perhaps you put Brady left back and you put McGeady ahead of him or something like that, and you really, really go and you let them rip, because you can just drop another centre midfielder in the two centre halves and just let the fullbacks push on, let Christie and Brady, if it is, push on. So yeah, no, there's loads of options there, and we have there's a couple of exciting youngsters coming through as well, and it's hard to say will the likes of O'Dowda etc be thrown in, but they're options.
He's thrown in against Moldova. That's the only reason I'm saying that. They've even started the game.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
And very good game as well.
And he's been scoring as well.
Yeah,
it's
bang on form. So, I don't see too many changes being made on the starting lineup, I have to say. But there is options there.
Yeah.
Which is the key part, really, because I think subs are going to have a big say on this over the course of the two legs.
Yeah, well, the bizarre thing about the left back thing is Steve was calling for Enn Stevens to be in the squad, who has about 7 or 8 assists from left back, which is fairly decent in the championship.
Absolutely, absolutely.
But you look at it, and the last kind of couple of games, keeps going off injured. I don't know where
if it's injured or he just completely gassed himself.
Well, I don't know, because at the moment, he's only back in training today.
Mm-hmm.
But he seems,
and that was put down to fatigue as well. That's what the diagnosis was. So yeah, it's a two-legged playoff. I'm sure he'll have enough adrenaline there to get him through.
Yeah, but this is just the thing. It's just like, why you have it. Yeah, I've covered for your right back. Why not have him for the left?
I'd imagine he's looking at the Brady option. Yeah, he has to be.
He'd have to be, I suppose.
Yeah.
And then, obviously, Hendricks trained today, so that's great news. That's a big boost.
Huge
boost.
Cause
he's flying.
Flying form, yeah. And he's another one of that bunch of ball-playing midfielders that we need to get on. Need to get on the pitch if we're going to have a chance over.
And he's a grafter as well. Like although he does the ugly work, but he can also score goals. Or I mean by the ugly work is, you look at the goal against Wales, that was simply down to him.
Just hard running.
Just
not
giving up on the ball.
Exactly.
Like that.
Two or three times he won it back there. Yeah. No. It's the one. Like, you asked me what am I most excited about. It's definitely our midfield. Because I know,
and we're without a lot of midfielders, but we come to that kind of later.
Well, yeah,
on,
of course, yeah. No, but there is loads of exciting ball player midfielders, which for years we haven't had, and it's exciting to watch.
Yeah,
and hopefully we will make use of them. And I've no problem packing the midfield with five and just having one up top, because there's enough of players there that have enough of quality to push on, and then we can add another striker if need be. But for the first leg, it's swamp midfield.
Yeah, definitely, and have Murph up top, sucking the ball in,
absolutely,
and
then
laying it off.
If defenders get tired, etc., throw on long then for another 20 minutes to go, and he's a total different outlet against tired defenders. But yeah, no, I would definitely start Murphy.
Yeah, 100%. I think a lot of people after the last game were like,
he proved himself there, because he's that grafter. He makes the ball stick up top. He gives an option. He allows runners to go past him. Some people were saying before the Welsh game that it was a very defensive team. But I'll kind of argue the opposite, because I know we definitely sat back and would have viewed a strike on the counter, but look at the goal we got. We had four people in the box.
Yeah.
And that's with a 4-5-1, so it doesn't have to be defensive. And with Murphy, that allows that outlet. So that's definitely the way to go in my mind. That's definitely how, if we are to have any chance of, like, we want the tide to be alive when we come back to Dublin. We don't want the whole everything deflated and all that. So the important thing, I think,
we don't
really
want any sending offs either, because
you look
at when we played Estonia, and that was the thing that killed them in the playoffs, and we got pretty lucky that day.
We did. We got a nice runner luck there. You can argue he was deserved after the campaign before.
but that's the thing. I don't want Karma coming back to striking on us now.
Yeah, no, definitely not. Definitely not.
And look at Duffy in the Orioles as well.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, no, but no, I'm really excited, I have to say. You know, really, really excited. And it's, isn't it great that we're... we've something so exciting to look forward to. It's a playoff, you know, halfway through the campaign it looked like it was done. It was gone. And then turning results. Like after the Serbia game, I was never as depressed in all my life.
I know, and I was sitting in the press conference after Martin O'Neill and everything, and like it wasn't a very nice atmosphere to be around, and even the people walking out and the journalists and all that were all like, oh, he's done and all this. And then he comes out, signs a 2-year contract.
Yeah, the timing of that was mad, wasn't it?
Yeah. In fairness, he got his team selection against Wales and he was justified. And, you know, you got to give him credit for it. Like, I was giving him stick throughout the campaign as well, but I'll hold my hands and say I was wrong. Like,
yeah, no, he tends to get it right in a big game as well, doesn't he? You know, that's where he's...
Most of the time.
Most of the time, yeah. The Serbia one is the one that bites us in the arse the whole time,
yeah,
isn't it?
Sure. I think it was more a case of the Austria game. Had that referee not robbed us, quote James McLean, had the ref not robbed us, probably qualified. I mean, we would have qualified.
Yeah, probably. So. But there you are.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, so I'm just... We got through a kind of our stand 11 team
cool,
that we kind of picked in regards to the Denmark game or the first leg.
Mm-hmm.
So looking at it, we got
Randolph
same back five pretty much. It's
going
to be Christy in like for us. He might throw Doherty in, but I don't see him doing it in such a big game. So I'm going to say stick with Christy because he was good against Wales.
Yeah, and as you said, there isn't really a strong enough option, experienced option there to change that. It's Christy all day long for me.
Yeah, they don't really go near the other three. I think Roy's justified his left back spot now, and he's really improved.
Yeah, he's completely. I thought he was done last season. I really thought he was done, but no credit to him. He's had a complete renaissance, and he's just flying it at the moment. And you know, he has at times he has a wand of left foot on him as well, which is definitely an attacking outlet. And
the thing about him is the reason why he probably gets a lot of stick is he's legging up that wing and he just has his head down and just kicks it into the box without looking or trying to pick out anyone, and that's probably why he gets a lot of stick. But then he's well capable. He doesn't get mauled over for the ball against for Murphy.
Yeah, it was a beautiful ball. Now, and it was funny, he's very much an old school chalk in my boots, I'm not going to look, I'm going to whip it in.
Yeah,
but when you have a big man like Murphy, you might as well just get the balls in the box.
Yeah, but he looked up that time.
Yeah, it was before he nearly fell in a heap. He was totally, totally wrecked. But yeah, no, and you know, guaranteed first choice. Again, that back five picks itself. I can't see any change in that.
Yeah, now the big one. Now I was campaigning a lot of time for James McCarthy to be put in.
Mm-hmm. That's your blue nose inside you, isn't it?
No,
I know. I would agree. I'm just slagging you.
A lot of people now I get stick on Facebook saying I was biased by people because I said he was probably our best midfielder when he's fit. And when I say midfielder, I meant centre midfielder. And people were talking about the wingers
and stuff like that. No, I have your back here. I would have. I was really, really disappointed when I heard that he'd broken down again. Because
some people were texting me laughing about it. Is we'd rather have Glenn Whelan.
No, Jesus, no.
You wouldn't rather, but you have to take
it. You have to do it now. That's the thing. McCarthy would have been just the perfect option to take that number six role.
He came in against Chelsea and looked like he was never away.
Yeah, like, and he hit. Did he have like one game for the under 23s?
Yeah, he played a half.
And then he comes on and plays like that. And that's who you can tell he's an actual footballer. When a player that's been out for so long that has hardly kicked a ball comes in and doesn't look like he's ever been away. You know, he's a quality player, just riddled by injuries and a huge loss. Because he would have taken that number six.
And he would have marked Ericsson. He would have followed him everywhere. And, you know, probably marked him. He has a good habit of marking big players out of games. You know, he did it with Everton. A few times we played Wolfsburg away and he did it with De Bruyne and he was magnificent. He did it with Ireland when Long scored, Ozil. He marked him out of the game. At the time, Ozil was flying.
He was in red hot form at the time,
and he kept him quiet. People saying he was at fault for the goals in the Euros. I don't know what Euros they were watching, but
yeah, no, it's hard to put any sort of blame on him. It's a huge pity, I would say, because his career is just blighted by injuries, and you know, I hope the kid gets a break soon because he deserves it. He's a quality footballer. But yeah, no,
I think he's going to have to drop down a club. I think is next for him. He's well able to get in that team when he's fit, but I just eventually.
Yeah, well, look,
eventually
I don't mean this in a disrespectful way, but who knows what's going to happen with Everton? They could go out and buy another couple of midfielders, or he could just come back in and because let's be honest, I don't think there's in centre midfielder there isn't really many other players that I would pick over him in that Everton squad.
Yeah,
well,
he's seven, he's fit, he's up there definitely,
yeah.
And you know, his only problem is his injuries. It's like Owen Hargreaves. It's very similar to kind of him. Not probably doesn't get as bad as him, but it's that type of thing. So his quality just can't get in because he's just every time he makes a comeback he gets injured. A bit like Michael Owen as well. But anyway,
He won't be playing Saturday night, so I'll go old school. I'm putting Whelan in number six.
You have to. There's no one else. You can't put Hoover in Hoover in there because he plays kind of more advanced.
It's not a six.
Yeah, he's more of an eight.
Yeah, absolutely.
But look. That's kind of it, and then I suppose it'd be Arthur and then Hendrick.
Yeah, I'd like to see them either side of Whelan, and that's a fairly compact unit because you can pretty much say Whelan, keep an eye on Eriksen, there you go, that's yours, and then the two of them can play as a normal two then.
Yeah, well, we'll have to watch out for Delaney as well. Now he'd be a threat for them as well.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I know he's a good player.
Should be playing for us.
Should really with a name like that,
yeah.
Especially. But that three I think is good enough to dominate the game. Even with the likes of Eriksen there, if they can get a grip on them at field, and especially down to Arthur and Jeff Hendrick, if the two of them can get play some ball together, they have enough legs. They can pretty much play it both ways. They can do the dirty grafting and they can attack forward with some good football as well. So, and then you have either side of them. You know, you have a good bit of pace there. We're probably saying Brady and McLean as well.
Yeah.
I think that picks itself fairly
good.
Yeah,
and then Murphy.
And
top.
Then Murphy up top. Yeah, it's usually Martin O'Neill throws a surprise with his team selection. I'd be shocked if he does it here.
The only shock I could see, and you wouldn't have thought this 2 games ago, would be putting Shane Long in there.
Yeah, there's both ways of looking at it. I think I would prefer to start with Murphy and Brindle.
Yeah,
I know there's an argument for dropping Long and starting Long and just playing him a little deeper, and he can play one of the wide roles as well, but I don't think he's as effective there.
No.
I'm bringing him. I'd be like to see him brought on, you know, against tired defenders and.
Yeah.
Let
so a 4-5-1 essentially.
Yeah. You know, that's where we go.
But you can kind of mix it into a 4-3-3 weirdly. When we're on the break, we're 4-3-3.
Yeah, it can do. Yeah, because the Whelan,
Brady
and McLean can just push on forward, and the two of them split the, and I think there's enough players in there to be. There's enough shrewd tactical players in there as well to be smart like that. And as you said. A flick to a three as well if need be, and there's most of that core barring Whelan, you know, he's been out of the fray the last while, but the rest of the players there have played a lot of football together, and it's not really going to be nothing new to them, so I'd be, you know, that's a to play a game away from home, that's a pretty solid team. And
even with the injuries that we have,
yeah, that's the thing. That's the
and
most
suspensions, Myler.
Yeah, because Myler is a big loss at one line because he like McLean had is another one of these players that found his niche at international football. He looked amazing against Wales over there. It was a stupid.
He was very good against Serbia too.
Yeah, he was indeed. Yeah,
very
but
calm and like he
yeah.
got the ball, wasn't afraid to take it, and you just give it all simple.
Of course, yeah, no.
Without having to hoof it.
Like. Yeah, no, exactly, no. He that's the thing about him as well. He can break up a lot of play, but he can also get everything ticking as well. But
and he can also take out the best player. Like, look at John.
Yeah. Careful now. Does McLean get an assist?
Oh, I suppose he does. Yeah,
yeah.
I suppose he does.
Either way, they got him by hook or cranny. They
not
got
even
him.
A yellow card.
Yeah, yeah, no. We definitely got a bit of luck in that game, put it that way.
Yeah, but that's the thing. I find that karma does come back around to you, but in fairness, we've had a lot of heartbreak over the years. So I think we're kind of due a bit of luck.
Especially when it comes to playoffs, doesn't it?
Yeah. So, yeah, let's see how it goes. Let us know your thoughts on the starting 11. If you would change any of the players that myself and Johnny have put in there, let us know in the comments. I think.
Confident?
Same as yourself, really. I'm quietly confident.
Score draw?
My heart says 1-1.
Mm-hmm.
No, sorry.
Which one is it, head or heart?
I want to go 1-0.
Okay.
So, but I think it's going to be 1-0. I just want us to get an away goal, so that would satisfy me. I don't want to lose, just if we can get an away goal, I'd be happy with. My prediction, I'm going to go 1-1.
Yeah, I'm the same, 1-1 for me as well.
But I'd be happy taking that back to Dublin.
I'd be very happy taking a 1-1 back to Dublin because
we don't even have to score.
Yeah, we don't, but I think we would. I think we will score in both legs.
Yeah.
And because back in Dublin we can totally change, and you know, we can play long and play a two up front. Myler's going to be back there as well, so there's a lot more options.
Yeah, and hopefully nobody gets injured or suspended from the first leg.
That's the key. Yeah, discipline really, and you know, I spoke a little earlier about McLean and him controlling his aggression.
Yeah, when you look at the silly yellow card he got against Wales.
Yeah, he blew a gasket and just lost the plot in the last 5-10 minutes against Wales. I hope that, you know, he's zoned in. And it's not like we're Serbia where he's playing the quarterback role with 20 minutes to go. And that's not where you want him. You want him high up the pitch,
yeah.
Attacking down the wing. And if we can get the likes of him, Brady as well, I think there's another one that's crucial. We need to get him in the game. Because
yeah, he wasn't in the game against Wales.
No, there wasn't.
More Serbia.
No, but I know there's always the cliche, he's a threat from a set piece, etc. But yeah, no, I think set pieces are going to be crucial in this.
Yeah, especially with them too.
Absolutely. Well,
you don't want to give away any stupid foul pals.
No, the thing about it is Eriksson will stroke one in from 25-30 yards, so that's where I'm talking about the keeping the heads, keeping the discipline, and we've got to play smart and not so much put them under pressure, just control pressure.
Yeah.
Because there's a line, and often the case is a lot of players there that cross it, but you know, if we can get everyone online and everyone in the zone, I think we've a really, really good chance. And I would take the 1-1 draw and bring them back to Dublin. And
loving the positivity, John.
Yeah, come on, we can get them. Yeah, why not? This is exciting. Like, yeah,
this is it. I've been saying that.
Yeah.
I said, we are Ireland. Why can't we go to Wales and get a result? And
yeah,
we did it.
We
can
yeah.
do the same in Denmark. I just think that it'll be a draw. It's a hard place to go. They've got good players. And
decent record as well, you know. They haven't lost many games.
Take a draw, bring it back over. We crucially need an away goal because I feel like they will score in one of the games.
Yeah, no, the away goal is key, and I think we've enough there to get one. And especially as I harped on, long from the bench is a good option, especially if they get desperate.
Yeah, definitely.
But yeah, no, everyone's feeling confident, aren't they? And isn't it great that we're in a occasion like this? You know,
absolutely.
Halfway through, looked like we'd made a balls out of this altogether, but we're here. Come on, Ireland!
Yeah. Guys, don't forget to subscribe. We're aiming for the 1,000 subscribers for Christmas. We're almost at 700, only 23 away. So if you please subscribe. Johnny will show you where to point to subscribe.
Ding, ding.
Thank you very much for watching Irish Football Fan TV. Come on, you boys in green.
Come on, Ireland.